that dead stuff.
And what was he doing?
He was bleeding.
Why was he bleeding?
I don't know. He either got in a dog or a cat fight. Yeah. He was walking, too, in addition to bleeding, yes. It was his little back legs that were both bloody, and he's kind of limping.
How long have you known Bob?
Oh, since he was a street cat. He came in here with no owners, with abscesses, needed to be neutered, and his owner said, "We gotta do something for this boy." I said, "Okay," and we fixed him up, and Bob's been thankful ever since.
And once we got to keep him, we just dressed him up on the sly with doilies off the couch and things like that.
How did that
Nothing
start?
Said. Doing laundry, and he'd be in the middle of it, and we'd throw a pair of underwear over the top of his head or something, and it stayed.
And I used to do weather at 6:30 and 11 many years ago, and Bob said to me, he said, "I've got a great weather shot." So we got on the news, and I did the forecast, and I said, "I want everyone to take a look at this. This is old," and I couldn't remember the name. But I remember Bob's name because I've worked with him for years. So I said, "This is Bob the Weather Cat." I just said that. Right? And
it stuck.
Well, the phone calls came
in. They started coming.
And I get a lot of letters. "How is Bob the Weather Cat enjoying this sunny weekend? There's Bob. I went out and bought him a pair of sunglasses. It looks like Jackie Onassis there." That's the Jackie Onassis look. And, you know, this was Dress As You Please Day. And I wonder if that applied to animals. There's Bob the Weather Cat who donned his hat today in honor of this day.
You know, he was dressed very casually.
He was, and he followed the orders very strictly. Dress as you please. And you're saying, "Jeff, the weekend's here. What about Bob the Weather Cat?" Well, here was Bob today. Bob's going to a formal affair, so he has the bow tie on him. Boy, Bob gets tired on these weekends. Yeah.
What is it about him?
Well, our theory that we found that he was a stray, that some neighbors that were in the neighborhood before us, that when all the stray cats would get around to eat the food, that whatever food was left over, that as a young cat, he would sit there and take their abuse and wait for them and then eat. And so he sees us as larger cats, and he's just always...
We want you to take a look at something very unusual for Bob the Weather Cat, something that doesn't happen often to Bob. Now, before everybody writes in and protests, this is exactly what the vet ordered. He said, "Bob, I know you don't like water, but you need a bath, guy. It's the only way you're going to get rid of the fleas." So this is Bob Takes a Bath for Health Week. It is Friday, and in recognition of Fire Prevention Month, here is Chief Bob, always vigilant, always on the lookout for smoke or the least spark. Number one fire chief right there. In fact, he always has his hose just in case something happens to break out in the garden. Bob, pay attention. Might be a fire behind that bush. Here is the man, number one, got the first prize already, and he hasn't even been to the cat show. Decided he wasn't even going to bother to go because they gave him the blue ribbon already. Bob likes to get away with a cool bottle of imported wine and perhaps a couple of crayfish, or however you like to call them. But Bob's a real crawfish fan these days. He just discovered those and likes to get away for a little tete-a-tete with a few friends.
That's Bob, the weather cat, who's making an appearance at the cat show this weekend, my friends.
We want to know what it is that you feed him, those kitty downers.
Oh, did you see his ears?
Yeah.
Those aren't kitty downers.
You knocked your hat off last night, didn't you? And I just
Come on.
Hey, let me get the door open.
Get me out of here.
Get the door open.
He's tired.
Always can you go anywhere with her?
No, if we do, we have to watch at 11.
It's a little late for graduation, but Bob finally made it. He had a couple of makeup tests to do, one in mole catching and another one in cheese eating. But somehow Bob has passed the test, and he is now a proud graduate. It's a new album that's about to be released called Waylon, Willie, and Bob. He's decided to go on the road with Willie, and he's always wanted to be a rock star. So now you will address him as Waylon Bob.
Thank you. Tonight, Bob's going to show us what a real cool cat wears. As the chilly days of winter give way to the often showery days of early spring, you can be sure that this famous feline will always be prepared for any change in the weather. Yes, it's our own Bob the Weather Cat. Bob enjoys the wide variety of spring weather here in the Northwest because it gives him the chance to wear one of his many new spring outfits. While most of us have to take advantage of sales and markdowns to round out our own wardrobes, not so with this most princely of all pussycats. Bob picks from a large wardrobe of high-fashion outfits and accessories, most lovingly created expressly for him by his fans. And should Mother Nature grace us with a few days of warm, sunny weather early in the spring, you can be sure that Bob will be more than prepared with one or more pair of designer sunglasses from his own extensive collection. It all kind of makes you wonder where that expression, "It's a dog's life," ever came from, doesn't it?
On this Cinco de Mayo, Bob's out doing a little Mexican hat dance.
Dusty air. Make your home a cleaner, healthier place. Call a day and night dealer to the rescue for a day and night electronic air cleaner. It can remove 95% of the dust, dirt, and pollen in your air. And if you have pets or allergies, it can really help. So call day and night to the rescue for an electronic air cleaner and for energy efficient heating and cooling systems.
Contact your local day and night dealer.
Insurance is puzzling sometimes, but your State Farm agent can put it all together for you. The best value in car insurance. Low-cost coverage for your home. Life insurance. Coverage for your health. Everything fits together when all your family insurance needs are served by one person. Your State Farm agent.
There's a State Farm agent in the Greater Portland, Salem, Vancouver area ready to help you. So look for the agent nearest you and call today.
For everything you need for a delicious Easter dinner, count on Safeway. Come in for special holiday savings on tender, juicy, bone-in Hamilton hams. Shank portion, just $1.08 a pound. Nothing makes a fresher Easter dessert than red, ripe strawberries. Sweet and juicy, they're just 69 cents a pint. From all of us at Safeway, happy Easter.
Nobody does it better.
Care to solve the puzzle?
I'm a wheel washer. I'm a wheel washer. It's America Day.
Tonight at 7:30 on KATU Channel 2.
National attention will soon be focused on Channel 2's Bob the Weather Cat. Pat Wilkins reports Bob will be featured in an issue of the National Geographic Society's World Magazine.
What with the country's mania for cats, Bob the weather cat is a feline in the right place at the right time.
Okay, now you slowly move towards him. Just slowly.
This superstar treatment he's getting from National Geographic doesn't surprise his fans, but it's quite a come up from the days in which, as a scrawny bundle of defiant fur called Hank, Bob scratched out a living in the alleys of southeast Portland. Portland freelance photographer Dave Faulkner is one of Bob's fans, and how fortunate it is that Dave does work for National Geographic. He told them about Bob, and they told Dave to do a story for World Magazine, one of the society's publications for young people, a magazine with about 1.5 million circulation. Dave says it's all pretty involved. First, the publishers ran a background check to authenticate Bob as the nation's unique, only weather cat.
Then they run a test. They actually go out and ask the school children in Washington, D.C., would you be interested in this? Then they might even hold a meeting and have a psychologist says, oh, this would be a great one for kids, or this wouldn't be.
So Dave has been snapping dozens of pictures of Bob, both at home and at work, a lot of them in company with weatherman David Apple. Faulkner is also interested in things like Bob's wardrobe and has posed the weather cat in various ensembles. He might also be interested in the fact that although Bob hates dogs, even his own toy dog, he does have concern for other animals, particularly homeless animals. That concern was demonstrated recently when sidekicks Bob and David donated over $100 to the Oregon Humane Society. It was money the weather cat earned through sale of pictures at a cat show. Of course, of principal interest, pertinent to the story and the reason for it, is Bob's job. Once a week, generally on Friday, Bob dons wardrobe that reflects the weather, holidays, the season, things like that. He is the visual backdrop for fonted weather information, a study in nonchalance as Apple intones the forecasts. Some other cats might think it's a pretty cushy job, but believe me, Bob works awfully hard to make it look easy.
You're not doing this on spec, I tell you.
Nope. No, this is an assignment. This will be published, and in their case, probably the earliest would be in 6 months. You'll probably see this next summer.
Of course, Bob can't read. At least we don't think he can read. But if he could, he'd learn he's in good company, being the subject of a World Magazine article. In the most recent issue, China's giant pandas are featured. In Portland, Pat Wilkins, Channel 2 News.
I knew it was just a matter of time. Bob the weather cat has upstaged us all.
Uh-oh. Yeah, Bob has gone national now. There is no doubt about it. Bob has definitely hit the big time. If there were any doubt about it, wait till you see this video. You've probably heard the rumors. National Geographic assigned local photojournalist David Faulkner to do an article on Bob the weather cat several months ago. And it was and now has appeared as the August edition of World Magazine. It's a magazine that's distributed to children in schools. I don't usually run pictures of animals that dress like people, but for Bob, they made an exception, not just an exception. Bob hit the front cover of World Magazine. He is their pinup this month. Not only the front cover, but 6 pages inside of Bob and all his poses, disguises, costumes, and a lot about the history of Bob the weather cat that we all love so well. So I guess we'll be hearing from all over the world from new Bob fans as this magazine makes the schools for back to school time.
Bob the weather cat, who's now become somewhat of a celebrity on a national scope since he appeared in National Geographic's World Magazine on the cover, has been getting fan mail. In fact, each day he waits for the arrival of the postman to see how much fan mail will be arriving for Bob the international jet set famous weather cat. And boy, does it pile up.
It's a face we all know and love, even though his outfits change every week. After appearing on Channel 2 for several years, Bob has certainly had his share of attention. But now, the country's only weather cat has a coup. This week, our boy Bob is in the middle of, what else? People magazine. We tried to get Bob to comment, but he didn't seem much impressed with an advance copy of the magazine. So we asked his agent if success has spoiled Bob yet.
He doesn't even know he's successful. We don't treat him like a superstar. He's just another animal who happens to wear clothes.
Still, it isn't every cat that has his own line of greeting cards and bumper stickers, nor do most felines head for the door wearing glasses and a tie. But when he's outside and off duty, Hank, as he is known in the neighborhood, is just one of the guys. Well, almost.
I think I like Hank. And he's a weird cat, though. I don't believe a cat would wear clothes and TV and things. It's strange because my cat doesn't do it.
And if that weren't enough to keep all four paws on the ground, Bob now shares family attention with a new addition. Not a cat, but a baby named Molly, who happily is even more oblivious than Bob to Fame and People magazine. Melissa Mills, Channel 2 News.
Well, the next time you take a trip to the Washington Park Zoo, you'll have a new attraction to check out. It's the Great Northwest Paw Print Plaza, where six distinguished Northwest animals had their paws imprinted in cement for posterity.
Bob's local fans look forward to his weekly appearances on TV when he makes bad weather seem better and good weather seem great. Thank
you. It looks like he has 5 feet.
People who love and admire their pets expect professional full-service health care for their pets. That's why the American Animal Hospital Association promotes responsible health care. As the largest worldwide small animal hospital organization, each member is evaluated and accredited through on-site inspections. AAHA members maintain the highest professional standards. Your pet can receive the quality health care it deserves from these local members. The Feline Medical Clinic in Vancouver. Call 206-892-0224.
Pete Williams finally took the big step and started his own business. And right now, while he's waiting for an answer to his first bid, he really appreciates how Randy Croucher at Fred Meyer told him why the size and power of the IBM PS1 consultant would be able to handle his business, showed him the software and the fax machine that he could depend on to keep his business running. The Home Office Answer. You'll find it at Fred Meyer.
Out of the house at 6:30, at the station at 7. Hair? Makeup?
I missed that, I'm sorry.
Clothes?
Hair. She tells me what I shouldn't eat. She tells me if there's something on my tie or my coat. She tells me to straighten my tie, just like at home. I get it, you know, both ways.
I tend to get more upset about things than Jim does, so to see him and to listen to his humor and his sarcasm, it's great. It's my kind of humor, and I love it. I just love it.
My last time to even look at Bob the Weather Cat as we kind of say goodbye. You know, it is about Girl Scout cookie time, and our friend Bob the Weather Cat is in fact dressed up for Girl Scout cookies. And as he dresses up for Girl Scout cookie time, he is dressed as a Daisy Girl Scout. Now, Daisies are 5 and 6 year olds who attend kindergarten or the first grade. And Bob always likes to help out with fundraising. He's wearing a dress and a wig, and that's just part of the job. Bob kind of gets off on that, doesn't he?
But this is not a dress and a wig. Actually, this is a bow tie with glasses, and this is probably Bob's best imitation of David Apple.
No.
I guess this is a Bob's way of saying goodbye to you, David.
So we know that you're going to go to the Kidney Association to be executive director.
And we are happy to announce that the Bob the Weather Cat poster and calendar will be available soon. It's a benefit for the Oregon Kidney Association. Well, a big social event tonight at the Photographic Image Gallery. One of the big celebrities around town, Bob the Weather Cat, was there to autograph his poster.
That's why he's always his own director. When it's done, it's done.
Well, here's Steve. You ever sign an autograph, Steve, with a stamp like that?
No, I haven't. I need that one.
And Bob the Weather Cat is honoring our very own Steve Arena. He's in the sports office. The phone's been ringing off the hook all day with people saying, Steve, don't go. Bob is going to miss Steve, as we all will, and he's especially going to miss Steve's basketball.
Steve Arena to the news set. Steve Arena. Studio B.
He wants to say goodbye to our... And that's exactly how Steve walks down the hall, by the way, in case you've never seen him.
There he is.
And he even borrowed some of... hanging around the last time Steve got his hair cut and used the clippings to make his wig.
Wouldn't Jim Bosley like to get his hands on that?
Yeah,
well, Jim will.
Yeah. What a tribute.
Anything before we announce the winner? Difficult contest, Jim?
It was really hard. The difference between the winner and the number six cat was just that much.
Really?
It was really tough to decide.
Would you say by a whisker, then?
Exactly.
I thought so.
The winner of the first annual Bob the Weather Cat Wannabe Contest is Milo Pilo.
Hey, there's Bob the Weather Cat. He was at the Blazer game tonight.
He's just sort of sitting on the bench doing his Rick Adelman impression and doing a Jerry Sloan is Milo Pilo.
And there they are getting ready.
they might actually be able to inbound the ball. No? Well, maybe not. Anyway, there you have it. Milo Pilo, winner of the Bob the Weatherbee Wannabe contest. Did I say that right or
yeah,
what?
You did.
Okay,
yeah.
Thanks.
Boy, Milo blends right into the floor of the gym there.
You know, you can only get this here on Channel 2. You can't get this anyplace else. Well,
don't they look excited?
Oh, they do. He gets a standing ovation.
We'll let Lou talk about how the Blazers did tonight in Salt Lake.
Yeah. Blazers could have used Bob to scratch Karl Malone's eyes out. That would have helped.
Well, after Wednesday's game, Rick Adelman put in a call to our secret weapon back here in Portland. Bob suited up and flew back to Chicago, where he will offer moral support, if not some long-range three-pointers, for our boys tonight.
Bob is in Chicago, too?
Notice he's wearing number 9, because cats have 9 lives. Not because he's a Danny Ainge fan, although maybe he is. It's a good-looking weekend coming up, and here's a good-looking cat. He's dressed for the annual Aloha Senior Prom, which starts at 5 o'clock tomorrow in Pioneer Square. Now, this is a dance with a tropical theme. It is aimed at senior citizens, and big band lovers of all ages are welcome. It's a free event. Woody Height will be playing at Pioneer Square.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
Bob's going to the prom.
Bob can do a meme cha-cha, let me tell you.
Supposed to wear your Hawaiian shirts to this.
That's right.
Or
right.
Your muumuu, whatever.
Whatever, yeah. I don't think I'll wear a muumuu.
Yeah.
The Ides of March, and there he is, dressed as Julius Caesar. He's on the lookout for Brutus. Brutus, as it turns out, is the dog next door. As many of you know, Bob the Weather Cat has been an honorary Rosarian for the last 6 years. He dropped off some home movies of his knighting ceremony today. If you missed the eclipse, here's one more look at it. It's brought to you by our own Bob the Helio Cat. There he is. Bob's the moon, and his hat is the corona of the sun. You may wonder, while I'm out here pushing the button, who's manning the controls back in the Weather Center? Well, now you know. Notice the computer mouse there. That's how we control most of the activity there. There you go. That's how we do it here.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Dirty, dusty air. Make your home a cleaner, healthier place. Call a Day and Night dealer to the rescue for a Day and Night electronic air cleaner. It can remove 95% of the dust, dirt, and pollen in your air. And if you have pets or allergies, it can really help. So call Day and Night to the rescue for an electronic air cleaner and for energy-efficient heating and cooling systems.
Contact your local Day and Night dealer.
The King of Closeouts has done it again. How much would you pay for a complete real oak bedroom set with 4-poster bed, 2 nightstands, and matching high-low chest on chest?
But wait, there's more.
This matching 8-drawer dresser is included as part of the package. Now how much would you pay?
But that's not all.
This beautiful trifold mirror mounts above the matching dresser. Don't pay exorbitant other store prices. No Fault Wall has made all 8 pieces $19.99. City Liquidators, second floor, new home furnishings.
Be there.
Be there.
When it comes to staying informed, the team spirit of Channel 2 News has you covered. I'm Julie Emery.
And I'm Jeff Giannola. Weeknights at 5, we believe it's important to show you news live as it happens. Plus, we take the time to bring you special reports and features you see only on Channel 2.
Every night, we give you the consistent, quality news coverage you've come to expect.
So when you need to stay informed, stay with a team you've come to trust.
Weeknights at 5, rely on the team spirit of Channel 2 News.
Cats are incredible about hiding their symptoms. They don't show you they're sick until they're very, very sick. He didn't have any energy. It's pretty obvious that he felt pretty rotten. And for Bob, he's a pretty outgoing cat, and so he was doing all his normal things until his body wouldn't let him do it anymore.
March 10th, 1993. Dear folks, I wanted to write a few lines to let you know that all of us here are feeling very saddened by your loss. I also wanted you to know how grateful I am to have been able to share just a little time with Hank. I am one of the overnight technicians here and was on duty Sunday and Monday night while we were caring for Hank. It is the nature of this business that we are, unfortunately, confronted by these tragedies on a daily basis. After several years, we become toughened by constant exposure to death and begin to believe we are distant enough not to take it personally. And then along comes those few special pets like Hank. It's not the fact that he was a celebrity. I think what drew me so close to him was his quiet dignity. He seemed to have a very strong sense of who he was and became friends with everybody here. Hank was always calm, always seemed in control. Last night, as I would look in on him, I could see that his sickness was becoming too much for even his stoicism. I have to say, I learned a valuable lesson from him. When my time comes to leave this life, I hope I can face it with the same dignity as Hank did. I certainly won't forget your little friend with the knowledge of a thousand worlds in his eyes. Respectfully, Mark H. Trulin, CVT.